This unit has been organized into topics that allow you to easily follow the instruction and learn systematically. Most of the topics have 7 segments. They are: first, design analysis; second, overview; third, manual demonstration; fourth, virtual fitting; fifth, comparison; sixth, self-assessment; and seventh, exercise. Design analysis is a graphic video. It will give you an idea about the final design of the garment. The graphic captures all the design features, and these are explained in detail. Sometime, if required, more than one design is explained for your benefit. You may also see 360-degree view of the design. When viewing this video, you may pause or run slow motion to get the clear idea about the design. Once you understand the design analysis, you may move on to overview. Overview is again a graphic video which gives you an idea about how to manipulate the patterns. A useful feature is the step-by-step reference that gives the instruction from the beginning to the end. If you are experienced, you can manipulate the pattern to suit your requirement by watching the overview. The overview will run less than 5 minutes, so I suggest that you watch it repeatedly till you understand the process thoroughly. This is followed by manual demonstration. In the manual demonstration, the actual pattern manipulation is demonstrated, while the overview will give you a better idea about the pattern manipulation. Manual demonstration explains in detail the procedure to actually perform the task. It will be a lengthy video, as the pattern manipulating process is thoroughly explained here. Additionally, you may see the various techniques such as pattern drafting, cutting, labeling, and truing. Next to manual demonstration is the virtual fitting 3D animation. This animation explains about the position of the patterns on the body. It also gives an idea about how to stitch the garment using blue color stitching line. Observe these lines carefully to get an idea about how to stitch. Virtual fitting also shows the 3D simulation of how the two-dimensional patterns are converted to three-dimensional shape after stitching. Generally, each part of the garment is rendered with different fabric to differentiate the various garment parts. Proper stitching details such as single needle lock stitch on the dots are also given to get the better visualization. This 3D simulation is done on different positions. This will help you get better understanding of the fitting. In this video, you may also find the wire mesh design of the garment. In the wire mesh mode, you can clearly see the relationship between garment and the body. You can also see how garment fits on the body, stitch lines on the body, dots, both starting and ending position, and garment flares, etc. The models are rotated to get the better understanding on how it fits all over the body. This will be a short video. It is advisable to view this many times to get most out of this video. The virtual fitting is followed by comparison. In the comparison, generally the basic pattern fittings or source pattern fitting is compared with the manipulated pattern fitting. It shows the step-by-step comparison by rotating both the garment 360 degree in the same position. This will allow you to compare the front, back and side of the model and gives you a better understanding about the manipulated design. I suggest that you either pause the video or move the slider forward or backward to get most out of this video. The design analysis, overview, manual demonstration, virtual fitting and comparison is a guide to understand the design efficiently and will give an excellent idea about how to manipulate the pattern and its fitting. Now it's time for self-analysis. You can make your own basic bodice pattern. Please refer unit 2 on how to make your own basic bodies. If you do not have the basic bodies, you may download the required pattern for the demonstration purpose. You may find the initial or start pattern that are required for the particular topic. All the patterns are available in PDF format. The patterns are in actual size. Users have some options while taking printouts. Option 1, if the user has large size plotter, example 36 inches or more, you can take the actual size easily. You may also use the CAD printer. Option 2, if you have A3 or A4 size printer, use the poster printout option like Adobe Reader. A separate video is included here that explains the procedure to take the poster print and join the printouts together to get the original size pattern. Option 3. You may take the printout in reduced size like 50% or 25% scale so that the pattern fits into A3 or A4 size pattern. The final pattern may also be taken in the same scale for verification. I have taken printout of front basic bodies. I enable the label so you can see the numbers here. This shows 1,1, 2,1, 1,2, 2,2. Spread as per the numbers. I given 1/2 inch overlap so that if something goes wrong, I have a 1/2 inch space to play with. So you can see F is printed on both the sheets. Draw the lines. I'm drawing the center line. Then fold the line.
and match it. So make sure that you are getting a smooth continuation. And put the tape. Then cut the pattern. You can use this pattern for other demonstrations.
Once you have completed the self-analysis, you may move on to the exercise. In the exercise session, you may find some additional exercise. Try these. You may attempt these designs using the pattern making technique learned earlier. Finally, for the best result, view the videos carefully and repeatedly. This will help you get the best out of this course.
This unit comprises of 7 modules. It's about the basic color, like color terminology, type of colors, etc. Flat color drafting. In this module, step by step instruction to make flat color is explained. We're going to make convertible color patterns, explain how to make shirt collar, collar stand, full roll collar, drafting will be explained. We'll explain how to draft a shawl collar and its variation. We'll discuss about the notched collar and its variations, and in review section that invites you reflects what you have learned. Objective of this collar unit is to understand the collar terminologies, different type of collars. It makes you draft basic collars and understand the different type of different roll types. Explain the difference between convertible and non-convertible collars. Understand how to draw different grain line in the collar. Draft shawl collar and notch collar. This module comprises of 3 topics: collar terms, collar stand and roll types, collar classifications. Neckline edge. It is the side of the collar which is attached to the garment neckline. It should match with the garment neckline. Notches should be marked on the neckline edge to match the correspondence notch in the garment to achieve perfectly balanced collar. Collar edge or style line. The outer edge of the collar is called collar edge. One can create many designs in the collar edge. It is also called as style line. Notches are marked if necessary. Collar stand. Collar rise from the neck level at the center back is called collar stand. While deciding the collar stand, wearer's comfort should be considered. Some collar designs like mandarin collar have only stand. Collar like Peter Pan collar will not have any stand. Some collar like shawl has both collar stand and fall. 1-inch collar stand is commonly used in many designs. Let's see about the fall. It is a part of the collar that extends from the top of the collar stand. It turns back and covers the stand and neckline seam. Mostly, the fall measurement should be bigger than the stand. Let's see about the roll line. Roll line is the folding line formed when collar falls turn down. Break point. It is a point at which lapel turns back on itself. Upper collar. It is the outer or visible part of the collar. Under collar. It is inner or underside of the collar. The seam line of the style line should be rolled to underside. This will produce neat look and seam line will be hidden. This can be achieved by adding 1/16 inch to 1/8 inch based on the fabric thickness on the upper collar, or removing 1/16 inch to 1/8 inch to under collar. This should be done only on the style line or collar edge. Many ready-made manufacturers use the same pattern for both upper and under collar to foster production. Collar neckline shapes determine the collar stand, and you can see the comparison of different collar neckline. Flat collar. These collars produce 1/8 inch stand just to cover the garment neckline. The fall will cover the body parts and it has deeper concave shape in the neckline. It allows to create various style lines in the collar edge. Peter Pan collar, Bertha collar and sailor collars are commonly used flat collars. Partial roll collars. It produce 1/2 inch stand at the back. The neckline will be concave shape, but it not deeper like flat collar. Full roll collar. It produce 1 inch stand and the fall will be cover the stand and neckline. Convertible collar. These collars can be worn as closed collar or open collar. Non-convertible. It is either open collar or closed collar. Example, notch collar. This module comprises of 3 topics: Peter Pan collar, Bertha collar, sailor collar. In the collar style line, the ends are rounded, then it is called Peter Pan collar. The rounded edge may be given only in the front or both front and back if the style line has back opening. Peter Pan collar may be designed with pointed, scallops or rounded. Upper collar should roll under collar to hide the seam at the style line. Upper collar draft may be 1/16 inch to 1/8 inch bigger than under collar to achieve this effect. But many ready-made garment manufacturers use upper collar and under collar as same as for faster production.
Peter Pan collar may be developed from any upper body sloper. In this example, I am using basic bodies front and back. Use front pattern without shoulder dot. In the front pattern, label A at center front neck, label B at shoulder at neck, label C at shoulder at armhole. In the back bodies, label D at center back neck, label E at shoulder at neck, label F at shoulder at armhole. C to G equal to 1/2 inch at armhole. This will produce 1/8 inch roll. It will just hide the neckline seam. Rotate the back bodies and match E to B. Pivot at B and rotate the back bodies till the shoulder line meet G. D2H equal to 1/8 inch extended beyond the center back line. A2I equal to 1/4 inch marked down from center of neck at center front line. Draw a new neckline from H to I through B. Draw collar style line as required. This example shows 2.5 an inch parallel line from center neckline. Make round shape and reduce to 0 at center front or center back or both according to your design. Trace the collar as highlighted. Mark the notch at shoulder at neck. Cut the pattern which gives you outer collar. Generally, under collar is reduced 1/16 inches to 1/8 inch according to the fabric thickness. To hide the collar style line seam, draw a line 1/8 inch at center back collar style line and 0 at center front. Trace the pattern as highlighted. Cut the pattern which produce under collar. Flip the pattern since right side of the fabric goes under for the under collar. Complete the pattern by labeling, marking grain lines, making notches and adding seam allowances. Peter Pan collar drafting completed.
This draft shows the variation of Peter Pan collar. For flat Peter Pan collar, do 1/2 inch overlap at shoulder. For collar with 1/2 inch strand, do 2 inch overlap at shoulder as shown. Construct Peter Pan collar and trace. For 1 inch strand Peter Pan collar, do 4 inch overlap at shoulder. Through the neckline and drop the collar as shown. Now it is showing superimposed pattern of flat, partial roll and full roll Peter Pan collar.
To make the Peter Pan collar, use front and back pattern. Label A at center front neck. Label B at shoulder at neck. Label C at shoulder at armhole. Similarly, in the back bodies, label D at center back neck. Label E at shoulder at neck. Label F at shoulder at armhole. From C, mark 1/2 inch down. Then label G. C to G, 1/2 inch. Since 1/2 inch is giving just 1/8 overlap at shoulder seam, at neck seam, please just cover the neck seam. Then rotate the pattern, match E and B. Match E and B and pivot at B and move the pattern till it touches G. The shoulder line touches G. Once it touch, put the pins. So now I overlap 1/2 inch here, E and B just touching. Extend the center back line and mark 1/8 inch from D. And label H. This is just 1/8 inch. Then from A, mark 1/4 inch and label I. A to I, 1/4 inch. Then mark E. Trace the pattern around 3 inches from here. Around 3 to 4 inches down. And mark shoulder at neck. Then remove the pattern. Now you got the actual neckline, but we are extended 1/8 here and reduced quarter inch here. Redraw the neckline by a smooth line from H to I through B. B is a soldered neck. Make a smooth line. The green color line is the new neckline. Then from that you can decide your Peter Pan collar width. Here I am taking 2.5 inch. So I am marking 2.5 inch parallelly. Mark a point. From the new neckline, mark parallelly 2.5 inch. From center back to center front. If you connect all the points, it will make a Peter Pan collar. Make sure you are starting it 90 degree here. This Peter Pan collar, normally you can make it as a round shape, either at the center back or center front, sometime both the side according to the opening. If the opening at the center front, make the round shape at the center front. The opening at the center back, make the round shape at the center back. Sometimes you can make both the side round shape. In this example, I am going to make round shape at the center front. So this gradually reduced to zero at center front. So this is 2.5 inch width and we made a Peter Pan collar. Normally this will give you upper collar. For under collar, normally it will be reduced 1/16 inch to 1/8 inch to hide the style line seam. So if you want to make it smaller one, mark 1/8 inch inside the collar style line. This will help you roll the upper collar to under collar. Gradually reduced 0 at the center front. 0 at the center front and 1/8 at side. Thank you. So the red color line shows under collar, the green color line shows upper collar. Trace the pattern separately and mark the grain line parallel to center back and add notches and seam allowance to complete the pattern. This will give you upper collar, but you have to turn the pattern trace the pattern. This will give you upper collar. Trim the 1/8. So 1/8 reduced, flip horizontally because the right side will go down, then trace the pattern. Which will give you under collar. Draw the grain line parallel to center back. Mark the notches. Cut 2. Cut 2. Add the notches and add the seam allowance to complete the pattern. Your Peter Pan collar is ready.
A Bertha collar is wide, flat collar that extend to the shoulder or may go beyond the shoulder. Mostly it is designed with rounded style line, but it may be designed with V shape at the opening. One can increase the neck width if required.
This video shows how to draft Bertha collar. Use front and back pattern. Pivot the pattern at shoulder at neck and rotate the pattern till it overlap 1/2 inch at shoulder at armhole. Extend 1/8 inch at center back line. Reduce 1/4 inch at center front line through the neckline. Mark 6 inches on center back. Mark 5 inches at center front line. Draw Bertha collar shape from center back to center front as shown. Trace the highlighted area which gives upper Bertha collar. Reduce 1/8 inch at outer edge and 0 at neckline as shown. Trace the highlighted area which gives you under Bertha collar. Label the pattern, Bertha collar draft completed.
Bertha collar. Use front and back pattern to make a Bertha collar. Label A at center front neck, label B at shoulder at neck, label C at shoulder at armhole in the front pattern, label D at center back neck, label E at shoulder at armhole, label G at shoulder at neck, label F shoulder at armhole. C to G is 1/2 inch for 1/8 overlap. Once you label it, match E and B together and rotate the pattern till the shoulder line touches G. Match E to B and rotate the pattern till shoulder line touches G. secure the pattern with pins. Trace the neckline. Center front line, center back line, and mark the point G and E. Then remove the pattern. Extend the center back line, mark 1/8 inch above, and in the center front line mark 1/4 inch down. Here you have to reduce 1/4 inch, here you have to increase 1/8. Redraw the neckline. Starting at 90 degree, around 3/8 of an inch. Then redraw the neckline. The red color line shows the new neckline. Then decide your bertha collar width. So in this example, I am taking 6 inches at the center back and 5 inches at the center front. The bertha collar should cover the shoulder. So you check your shoulder. So it is 5 inches. So I am taking more so that it should cover the shoulder. Mark 6 inches at the center back and 5 inches at the center front and 5.5 inches at the shoulder. Draw a smooth line, so 6 inches I am marking. 5, 3, 4. I'm reducing 1/8 here, 1/4 inch here, 3/8 here, 1/2 inch here. Similarly, draw a smooth shape. Then cut the pattern. draw the grain line parallel to center back. This will give you upper collar. Cut to. For making under collar, flip the pattern horizontally. Reduce 1/16 to 1/8. Draw a grain line parallel to center back. This is produce under collar. Cut to. Then mark the notches at the shoulder. So your bartha collar is completed now.
Sailor collar is another flat collar which has V shape at the front opening and square shape at the back. Front neckline also changed to V shape according to the collar shape.
This video shows how to draft sailor collar. Use front and back body's pattern. Pivot the pattern at shoulder at neck and rotate the pattern till it overlap 1/2 inch at shoulder at armhole. Extend 1/8 inch at center back line. Mark 8 inches at center back line and draw 7 inch perpendicular line. Draw a line parallel to center back from perpendicular line to shoulder. Mark 6 inches at center front line. Connect to shoulder as shown. Trace the pattern as highlighted. Add notches, which gives you upper collar. Reduce 1/8 inch bottom and side and 0 at center front as shown to make under collar. Flip the under collar. Label the pattern. Sailor collar draft completed.
Sailor collar. To make a sailor collar, use front and back pattern. Label A at center front neck. Label B at shoulder at neck. Label C at shoulder at armhole. In the front pattern, label D at center back neck, label E shoulder at neck, label F shoulder at armhole in the back pattern. C to G 1/2 inch, which will give you 1/8 overlap. Then match E to B, then rotate the pattern. Pivot at E till the shoulder line touches G. Pin it. Trace the neckline. Center front line and center back line. Mark shoulder at G and B. Remove the pattern. Center front, center back. Your sailor collar, according to your design, you mark the length. Here I am marking 8 inches. First, extend the line. Extend the center back line by 1/8 inch. Mark 8 inches on the center back line. Square the line. Mark 7 inches and draw the parallel line to the center back. Here 7 inches. And this is parallel to center back. In the center front, mark 6 inches. And draw the line from shoulder to center front line. This 8 inches, 7 inches, 6 inches is according to your design. Then redraw the neck shape from 1/8 inch to make a 90 degree here, starting at perpendicular line, small line, and touching the shoulder at neck. To the center front. You can make it as a slight curve also. This will give you sailor collar, which is upper collar. The under collar may be reduced 1/8 from here to here and 0 here. The red color line shows under collar, the black color line shows upper collar. Cut the pattern. Flip the pattern. Reduce. Inch. And gradually zero at center point and reduce 1/8. Cut the pattern. Draw the grain line parallel to center back. So your sailor pattern, sailor collar pattern completed. Add notches at shoulder and add seam allowance according to your requirements.